Hello everyone, the Lord Freak Karina is here once again, and today we will take a look back at Legion, the Maw of Souls dungeon, and the second boss of it, Harbaran in particular. Well, this one was actually an article I published in my blog back in October 12, weeks before it was revealed that there will be a Constellar boss in the upcoming raid of patch 9.2. If you have been following me for a long time, I am sure you are aware that I have been speculating about the direct connections between Death and the Void. And I have been saying they are not actually enemies at all. So, let's get into the video. What was the actual purpose of the Maw of Souls? First, let us remember what the Maw of Souls actually stands for, according to Wikipedia. Emits fog and mist. The cursed vehicle awaits the Naggifar, a fearsome ship formed from sinew and bone, which comes to deliver these poor souls to Helheim and the clutches of Helia. And Naggifar sails on a stormy, chaotic sea on its way to Helheim. So, when we defeat Ymiron, the first boss of the instance, what does he say?
Not again! Harbaran! Cast their souls into the tides!
If you have played Battle for Azeroth, I am sure you have realized the tide and the ocean were also associated with the void and the darkest depth. Whereas the people of Stormsong Valley believed the darkest creatures awaits them. It turned out those creatures were actually faceless ones, the Akir. So, in the culture of Coltrane, the depths should be feared while respected. Just like in our culture, in the real world, in some way, you know, the Cthulhu mythos. Moving on, we came across the second boss of the instance, Harbaran. From Wikipedia, Harbaran was the ferryman of souls and the second boss of the instance. It said that his connection with Helia is unclear. But when the breeze catches Harbaran's cloak, an expanse of shimmering stars unfolds beneath. At this point, it seems 100% clear that Harbaran was a Constellar. Zalatat had something to say about him as well.
It was thought his kind was incorruptible. A lesson for my brothers, I suppose.
So, maybe Yogg-Saron once tried to corrupt Algolon himself. If you remember, Algolon was the first Constellar we encountered in the lore. What are they? The Constellars are a race of mysterious celestial beings who resemble large humanoid-shaped constellations. During the early ages of the universe, when the Titan Pantheon brought order to countless worlds throughout the cosmos, the Titan leader Amantul called upon the Constellar to observe the many worlds ordered by the Pantheon. The Constellar stayed vigilant for any signs of instability and, when necessary, initiated a fail-safe procedure to scour a planet of life and reset its evolutionary process. So, a Constellar, Harbaran, once worked with Helia for reasons unknown, and he says this during the boss battle.
The flesh burdens the soul, a nuisance that must be flayed from your bones.
Another implication to flesh being actually a burden, a weakness. While Ignot calls it a gift of flesh, because becoming mortals granted us free will, it also weakened us a lot. When we get into the Helheim,
Helya and her cult are strong here. So close to the truth, yet so far.
What is this truth she constantly referred during Legion? Maybe the truth has been hidden in the sea, in the depths. Or are they just metaphors? Well, another quote from our mysterious Ferryman of Souls.
Life, death, I am but one ripple in the eternal ebb and flow.
Also,
now it is I who must pay the blood price.
The eternal ebb and flow. Fate scribe Rokkalo mentioned eternity in Sanctum of Domination Rites.
Eternity devours itself.
The representation of Ouroboros from the map of the Nameless Broker, the cosmic chart in the Eyes of Death, and most likely from the Eyes of the First Ones. So, this guy, Harbaron, knew about this cycle of eternity as well. And he was a debt collector, more specifically, blood or soul debt collector. And he was wielding a cosmic sight. Regardless, the connections between Helya, Odin, Yogg-Saron, thus the connections between Death and the Void, are undeniable. But of course, content creators still rely upon the idea of Death and Void are enemies, no other way at all, think, just because of a single line back in Three Sisters comic. Ridiculous. So, in my opinion, it's funny that our community have noticed the connection between Harbaron and Shadowlands only recently. Well, because at the time of Legion, we had almost zero knowledge about the Shadowlands and how it works. But as you can see, Blizzard put breadcrumbs back in Legion for the Shadowlands arc, just like how Nuzot warned us about the actual plot of Shadowlands through the entire battle for Azeroth. So, the next time you encounter someone who claims the Blizzard story writing is inconsistent, think about the little details scattered around the expansion. Because in truth, as I have said before, Legion, Battle for Azeroth, and Shadowlands should be considered as a single story. Also, we still do not know about Loco's final words to Odin. It seems when we learn the truth about the entire Helya and Odin arc, the Pandora's box will open, just like how thanks for watching. If you like this fun and would like to support me so I can keep doing speculations, subscribe to the channel, drop a like or comment. Until next time, which is soon, see you.